I see two advantages of high-speed interconnect in my research and applications. First of all, we can now do distributed computing. So at Deutscher Wetterdienst, we run a global model, which then provides data, so-called lateral boundary conditions for regional models in any region of the world. So we can transmit data to Africa, we can transmit data to Asia, and in the National Weather Services there, they can run a high-resolution regional model and provide detailed warning for the population there. And that helps really to save life. The second advantage I see is that forecasters and researchers in these countries can stay there and still do high-class research. They don't need to come to Europe, but due to the connection, they can work as if they are in Europe. With serious weather events, what we call high-impact weather, it's very important that the population has a chance to prepare. And normally, if there's a high-impact weather event like a storm or heavy precipitation, 24 hours or 48 hours ahead, a warning is enough for the population to prepare. So if the regional service can run a limited area model, high resolution, which predicts this event, then the authorities in this country can really warn. For example, in the situation of Philippines, heavy precipitation is usually due to typhoons. And with the model, we can predict the track and the intensity of the typhoon rather accurately. And so the local authorities can warn the population, and the population can then react onto this warning. Yeah, looking back at my experience during the past 30 years with the advent of the high-speed networks like Giant, like Tyne, like DFN in Germany, that really made a big difference in the way we at the research level and at the operation level can cooperate with people abroad. The way we cooperate, the way we interact with each other, and the way we can benefit our society really greatly improved via these networks.